الحمد لله رب العالمين، الحمد لله تعالى، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهد الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. Indeed, all praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our Lord, the gracious, the merciful, the master of the earths and the heavens, the king of the day of judgment, Azza wa Jal. And the prayers and the blessings of the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala be upon our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and be upon all those who follow in the footsteps of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Nashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah, wa nashhadu anna Muhammadan abdullahi wa rasuluh, وصفيه من خلقه وخليله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على الحبيب المصطفى. We bear witness that there is no Lord but the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his messenger. I remind myself and remind you to be pious, to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in everything that you do, to heed the orders of the Almighty Azza wa Jal when he says, يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون. Oh, you believe, be God conscious and die in no way except in the way of Islam. Oh, you believe, be God conscious and let every soul be aware of its own tomorrow and fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for he knows best what you do. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make this the cold of this day, insha'Allah, a blessing upon all of us, and to grant us, insha'Allah, the serenity and the blessings of this blessed day of Jum'ah. Allahumma ameen. My dear respected brothers and sisters, in line with reminding one another of the ibadat of the heart, of the worship of the heart, which comes in always as the foundations for everything that we do, which comes in as the way for us to find refuge in the face of challenges, in the face of difficulties. For if the heart is solid, and if the iman that is situated in the heart is strong, then insha'Allah, not only will it be addressed and said by the tongue, but rather it will be accomplished and implemented by the actions of all of us. And so we spoke about patience and tawakkul and rida and shukr and hamd and so on and so forth. Today I want to talk about what's called salamatu sadr, the cleanliness of the heart, the purity of one's inside, which is something that every one of us must take care of. Every one of us must look within and must reflect upon the heart that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us with. Is iman filling it with the mention and the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and with the fear of the Almighty Azza wa Jal, so that there is no place for any other illness in the heart. There is no vengeance, there is no spite, there is no hate, there is no ill feelings towards anybody, so that insha'Allah it can reflect in our deeds, and it can reflect in our behavior, and it gives us an impeccable character, and it gives us insha'Allah the complete of the best behavior that our beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was an example of. Everything we do within is everything that reflects without, on the outside. And it's very important for us to maintain that integrity, that the inside reflects the outside. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was once asked, who is the best of people? يسألونه صلى الله عليه وسلم أي أفضل الناس؟ فيقول صلى الله عليه وسلم كل مخموم القلب صدوق اللسان. قالوا مخموم القلب نعرفه يا رسول الله، فما هو؟ قالوا صدوق اللسان نعرفه يا رسول الله، فمن هو مخموم القلب؟ قال صلى الله عليه وسلم هو التقي النقي لا إثم عليه ولا بغي ولا غل ولا حسد. قيل فمن على أثره يا رسول الله؟ قال الذي يشنأ الدنيا ويحب الآخرة. قيل فمن على أثره يا رسول الله؟ قال مؤمن على خلق حسن. The Prophet ﷺ was asked, who is the best amongst us, who is the best of people, O Prophet of Allah. He said, Saduqul Lisan, the person who is truthful in what he says and what he does. And then he said the word Mahmumul Qalb. So they wondered, what does that word mean, O Prophet of Allah? They said, the person who is truthful in tongue, we know. What is Mahmumul Qalb? He would say he is the righteous one, he is the taqi, he is the God-conscious one who has no illness in his heart, who has no vengeance in his heart, who has no spitefulness in his heart. And as such, they said, what would make him as such? He said, he is the one who leaves this dunya behind and seeks the akhirah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they said, who is unto like him? He said, every believer with an impeccable character, with the best of character. Because if you work on your heart and you cleanse it from within, then you're giving yourself a chance to make the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to make the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be the occupants of your heart. So there is no other space for any other ill feelings. There is no time on this earth for us to waste hating one another, spiting one another, feeling ill against one another. Let us all remember to take it upon ourselves to be like the believers that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes in the hereafter when He describes the people of Jannah. When He says subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَنَزَعْنَا مَا فِي صُدُورِهِمْ مِنْ غِلٍّ إِخْوَانًا عَلَى سُرُرٍ مُتَقَابِلِينَ. We have removed any illness of the heart from amongst them, indeed as brothers who are living the blessings of the hereafter. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted the dua of Ibrahim alayhi salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعُ مَالٌ وَلَا بَنُونَ إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. Nothing would matter of this dunya. Not your wealth, not your children, not your power. Nothing will benefit you in the hereafter except coming with a clean heart. وَالَّذِينَ جَاءُوا مِنْ بَعْدِهِمْ يَقُولُونَ رَبَّنَا اغْفِرْ لَنَا وَلِإِخْوَانِنَا الَّذِينَ سَبَقُونَا بِالْإِيمَانِ وَلَا تَجْعَلْ فِي قُلُوبِنَا غِلًّا لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا رَبَّنَا إِنَّكَ رَؤُوفٌ رَحِيمٌ. That is the calling of the people of Jannah. Oh Allah, forgive us and forgive our brethren who have been preceded us in Iman, and do not make within our hearts any ill feelings towards those who believe. Oh Allah, you are indeed the most loving, the most merciful. And so if we were to look at how can we cleanse our hearts, then we need to learn that by filling it with the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by filling it with the taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we would leave no space for any ill feelings. We would leave no space for any of the worldly desires and lusts that takes over and that takes us away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as such, we must reflect that in our morals and in our behavior. We must look like the heart that we want to aspire to, so that we can achieve that integrity where our inside reflects on our outside. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam talks tremendously of the benefits of those who are of the impeccable character, who are of the best of morals. يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم عندما سئل صلى الله عليه وسلم عن أكثر ما يدخل الناس الجنة فقال صلى الله عليه وسلم تقوى الله وحسن الخلق. They asked him, O Prophet of Allah, what is the thing that enters most people or the most number of people into Jannah? He said, تقوى الله, the God consciousness and the best of morals. And he says, صلى الله عليه وسلم, أحب عباد الله إلى الله أحسنهم خلقا. ويقول صلى الله عليه وسلم, إن من أحبكم إلي وأقربكم إلي مجلسا يوم القيامة أحاسنكم أخلاقا. That the best amongst you and the closest to me in the hereafter are those who are with the best of morals. And he says, صلى الله عليه وسلم, ما من شيء في الميزان أثقل من حسن الخلق وإن الرجل ليدرك بحسن خلقه درجات قائم الليل صائم النهار. Indeed, he says there's nothing heavier in the balance of a human being other than his good morals. And with good morals and good behavior that reflects a clean heart, the man can achieve the degrees of those who make qiyam al-layl insha'Allah and those who fast the day. What if you can be both? You can be that who has the clean heart. You can be that who refuses to allow the ills of the heart to take over him, and to rather accept the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and accept the gifts from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be able, insha'Allah, to succeed in this life and to be amongst those who have the best of heart and in the best of behavior. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the ability to remain steadfast and to reflect and enjoy and cultivate, insha'Allah, the love of the Almighty Azza wa Jal and His taqwa. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوا إِنَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا وحبيبنا محمد sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear brothers and sisters, there is a powerful hadith that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reminds us of when he says, عليكم بالصدق فإن الصدق يهدي إلى البر وإن البر يهدي إلى الجنة وما يزال الرجل يصدق ويتحرى الصدق حتى يكتب عند الله صديقا. Truthfulness, honesty, integrity, when your inside reflects your outside, is indeed an achievement that can only be attained by those who love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and attained by those who want the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this life and in the hereafter. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the strength and the iman to be able to, insha'Allah, remain integral both inside and outside and to remain truthful to His message and to seek His pleasure. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgiveness and guidance. Allahumma afu anna waghfir lana warhamna. Anta maulana fansurna ala القوم الكافرين. اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا. اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها مولاي أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها. عباد الله, إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. فاذكروا الله يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون. وأقم الصلاة.